Please stand for the processional of graduates. Good afternoon, platform guests, parents, and friends. Welcome to the commencement proceedings of Hall Success Academy Class of 2023. We ask all who are present to remember that this is a very formal occasion and a serious occasion, and your total cooperation is necessary in order to make it a very special day for our seniors. Please remain standing for the presentation of the colors, the pledge to our flags, and the singing of the national anthem. Gentlemen, please remove your hats.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to thee, Texas, one state, under God, one and indivisible.
Please be seated. It is my pleasure to introduce our Curriculum Assistant Principal, Mr. Hector Luevanos.
There are a number of individuals who have worked very hard to make this day a special one for you and your graduate. As I introduce the platform guests, please hold your applause until everyone has been introduced. To my right, I have Dr. LaTanya M. Goffney, Superintendent of Schools, Mr. Randy Bates, Jr., School Board President, Dr. Kimberly Booker, Vice President, Mr. Steve Mead, Secretary, Ms. Rose Avalos, Assistant Secretary, Ms. Connie Esparza, Board Member, Dr. Viola M. Garcia, Board Member, Mr. Paul Shanklin, Board Member, Ms. Shalia D. Reed, Chief of Staff, Dr. Catherine Rohde, Chief of Schools, Dr. Javier Villarreal, Chief Human Resource Officer, Ms. Dawn Ayers Rodriguez, Chief Accountability, Assessments, and Analytics, Dr. Adrian Bustillos, Chief Transformation Officer, Mr. Adam Galvan, Chief Information Officer, Mr. Fred Washington, Chief Operations Officer, Ms. Kay DeWalt, General Counsel, Dr. Fabiola Cantu, Assistant Superintendent of Schools, and to my left, I have Principal Sierra Nickerson, Valedictorian Jasmine Hardwell, Salutatorian Joanna Sanchez, Pledge Reader Julian Franceschi, College Access Advisor Mr. Michael Rogers. I would also like to recognize other school personnel who may not be on stage, but are in the arena. High school counselor, Tony Stevens. Student support specialist, Britannia Washington Edwards. And all Success Academy staff members present. Please give them all a round of applause. At this time, I would like to recognize the parents of all graduating seniors and thank each of you for your support you have given to your child and to our school. Parents, please stand up. Today, we are honored to have some of our graduating seniors who have enlisted in one of the military branches, who have been accepted into one of the military academies. It is my honor to recognize these students at this time. Graduates who meet this description, please stand and be recognized, and let's give them a round of applause. We have many students who have worked very hard to earn one or more scholarships. These students are designated in the program with a star. Students, the work you have done to support your education has paid off. If you have earned one or more scholarships, please stand and be recognized. And let's give them a round of applause. It is always an honor and pleasure to recognize your moments of celebration. Congratulations again. Now, it is my pleasure to introduce the class of 2023 Salutatorian Joanna Sanchez.
Good afternoon, family, friends, faculty, staff, and fellow graduates of 2023. My name is Joanna Sanchez, and I've been granted the honor to give out the salutatory speech for this year's graduation. Today's an important day in our lives as we gather here to celebrate more than a decade of dedication and hard work. We have all accomplished one of the major early milestones of our lives, high school graduation. All of us had a unique mosaic of trials and tribulations that we had to overcome in order to stand here today. I want to thank the administration of Hall Success Academy, principal, assistant principal, and counselor for guiding me to become who I am today and for always cheering me on, for making me feel welcome and comforted. A special thank you to Ms. Kennedy for going out of her way to personally approach me so I could continue with my studies. Mr. L for brightening up my days during lunch with his jokes. And lastly, a mi familia por siempre apoyarme, mi madrina por acompañarme y ayudarme en mis años escolares, a mi papá porque me alentó siempre a luchar por lo mejor, y a mi hijo quien fue mi motivación más grande para salir adelante. With that being said, I would encourage all my fellow classmates to appreciate everyone who has contributed to your success. Those that will scold and lecture you to do better did it because they wanted the best for you. Parents, family members, and teachers, you have all been instrumental in our education. Today, as we move on to our next chapter in life, we will take with us not only the book learning, but also the life lessons we have been taught. As we stand here today, we have proven to ourselves that we are capable of overcoming many more milestones. And even though they will be accompanied with challenges, there should be no reason to doubt yourself. Because like my dad always says, todo en esta vida es difícil, pero no imposible. Everything in this world is hard, but not impossible. We each have encountered our own unique set of challenges. The choice is ours. We can either learn and grow from them or be defeated. Lord knows life is not, nor has it ever been promised to be easy. But if we look at our past and see what we have overcome, we know that our futures are bright. As I bring this speech to an end, I would like to quote Nicki Minaj, "Don't be lazy, push yourself. Even when you feel like you can't go on, continue to push." Finally, I would like to congratulate the class of 2023 for making it this far. Thank you. And salutatorian, I would like to introduce to you the valedictorian of Jasmine Hardwell.
Good afternoon, parents, students, and staff. My name is Jasmine Hartwell, and I am the valedictorian for Hall Success Academy's graduating class of 2023. First, I would like to thank God himself for making this day possible. I have always planned for this day, praying day and night for the day I graduate and go to college. Throughout my 19 years, I have been through many hardships and many difficult challenges. Going through those situations has taught me to appreciate the things I receive today, to know that the small things are what matter. I come from a family that has experienced financial issues, and we have had challenges settling in one place. We haven't been able to have great holidays, but we always prayed through it. With all these hardships and challenges, I was 2 years behind in school. Attending Hall Success Academy allowed me to persevere despite my challenges. My acceptance to Hall Success Academy was the biggest blessing I received. Hall has shown me what it is to be independent and strive for what is most important to me. No, it was not that simple, but in life, when you think about it, nothing is really easy. When I came to Hall, I was classified as a ninth grader because of credits. I finished every class with over 26 credits in only 1 year and 5 months. Not only that, I am number one out of the entire school as I stand here today. Hall Success Academy has made that possible. To conclude, today I would like to give a word of advice to everyone, students, teachers, and parents. When things seem to get hard and overwhelming, always stay focused, keep a positive mind, stay motivated, take baby steps, and all in all, pray. I want to thank you all for coming out. Congratulations to all graduates, and thank you to all staff. I would like to wish you all many more blessings in your future. Class of 2023, we are out.
Hall Success Academy, we are here. Graduation is always an exciting experience, and it is also an emotional one. I hope that you embrace this moment as you're being celebrated for your accomplishments and hard work. I know that along this journey, within this school year in particular, many of you have experienced some difficult times. You may have felt like you weren't moving fast enough, or there wasn't enough time, or that you were too far behind. You may have felt like your dreams were erased. You may have felt like giving up. And we're all so glad that you didn't. I want to remind you that as we look back over our challenges, that we always remember that what's in front of you is bigger than what's behind you. Yes, what's in front of you is bigger than what's behind you. And we can visualize this as we're driving or riding in the car. You see, the rearview mirror, although small, merely allows us to briefly reflect on the journey already traveled to ensure that the pathway we are forging ahead is clear. Keep moving forward. Those words are encouraging. It is impactful for your destiny, your promise, your future. Keep moving forward. A little progress each day adds up to big results. This makes me think of Aesop's most famous fable, the hare and the tortoise. You see, at the end of the story, we all remember that the tortoise wins the race, which is unexpected since the hare is so naturally fast and the tortoise is so slow moving. The hare, in its all of its self-perceived glory during the race, decides to nap, allowing the tortoise, who initially was far behind, to continue to plod along their journey at their pace to finish and win the race. The moral of the story may be that slow and steady wins the race, but we must also not miss a critical moment of the tortoise. In fact, the tortoise exhibited traits that you all as Hall Success Academy students personify. The tortoise stayed the course. The tortoise made consistent progress. The tortoise kept moving forward. You kept moving forward when this senior class alone, just this school year, completed over 500 courses. 7 students are graduating as 3-year graduates. Within this class, 4 students have earned their biliteracy cords. 4 students have received their community service cords, and 1 student is confirmed enlistment in the U.S. National Guard and is currently serving right now. Within this class, you kept moving forward when our CTE courses began working on our tiny home. Our science classes began building a garden. Select seniors participated in an apprenticeship with a technology company that yielded on-the-spot job offers. You kept moving forward when members of this class saw a need for change on campus and created a student leadership organization. You also began and sustained our first ever esports team. This class kept moving forward when you saw the need to help in our community and the idea of a community service organization came to fruition. Through this organization, 180 lives have been saved through blood donations, 3 busloads of trash were picked up along our bayous, and over 500 hours of community service have been accumulated. Class of 2023, you kept moving forward. As I close out this afternoon, even with all of this great news that I just recapped, what you all did was big. It has already happened. It is now behind us. I just want to remind each and every single one of you all that what's in front of you is even bigger than what's behind you. Your futures are bright. You're just getting started. You were built for this journey. Class of 2023, repeat after me. I got this. I got this. You got this. You were made for this. Congratulations, class of 2023. We are now ready for the presentation of the 2023 graduating class of Hall Success Academy. Dr. Goffney, would you please join me at the podium? Graduates, would you please stand? Superintendent, I am honored to share with you that these seniors, members of the class of 2023, have met the criteria to graduate. They have satisfied all requirements of the Aldine Independent School District and the state of Texas and are hereby entitled to be graduates of the Hall Success Academy with all the rights and privileges appertaining thereto.
Students, congratulations. Today is a day that you will always remember. I encourage you to cherish this moment in time. It is such a special time, a time that you can celebrate your accomplishments. Parents, families, and teachers, you too should be proud. The support you provided along the way is what has helped our graduates reach their goals. I encourage you to extend that support as they move on to the next chapter of their lives. President Bates, And members of the Aldine Independent School District Board of Trustees, I certify that the students who have met the requirements of graduation set forth by the Texas Education Agency and the Aldine Independent School District Board of Trustees are eligible to receive their diplomas. They should have all the rights and privileges associated with a Texas high school diploma. Congratulations, class of 2023.
Graduates, you may be seated. The format for awarding diplomas to our graduates enables us to focus more on the individual attention of each member of the class of 2023 by allowing you to share in the recognition of the honors bestowed upon each of them. The first 10 students represent the top 15% of their class and are listed on the program as graduating magna cum laude with honors or cum laude. They will march across the stage in order of their class rank. The first four students wear double cords to signify their magna cum laude status. The next six students will be wearing a single gold cord signifying their cum laude status. You will notice that many of the graduates are wearing different color cords on their graduation gowns. Cords indicate either membership in an organization, outstanding participation in a special program, or academic excellence. Students designated as foundation with endorsement plan graduate have completed specific curriculum requirements established by the state of Texas. And as a reminder to the audience, please refrain from any action that may cause a student's name not to be heard when it is read. Remember, this is a formal occasion. Will the first row of graduates please stand? The graduates will now come forward to receive their diplomas. Mr. Michael Rogers will call the names of the graduating class, and members of the Board of Trustees will present your diplomas.
Jasmine Hardwell. Joanna Sanchez. Evelyn Giselle Zapata. Jacqueline Arellano Castañeda. Denise Guerrero. Imzadi R. Lusto. Mariah Davis. Yvette Jasmine Arroyo. Yeah. Kenneth Amos Jr. Jasmine Ruth Burrell. Jasmine Buford. Jennifer Cortez Hernandez. Carter Dixon. Julian Josiah Franceschi. Israel Guerrero. Javian LaShawn Gobert. Alondra Guerrero. Carlos Augusto Hernandez. Anayeli Iseta. Alexis Dion Rose Jackson. Jelani Darnell Keel. Damon Prescott Lucher. Eva Leyva. Isabel Marie Machado. Michaela Nicole Martinez. Virginia Lynn McCall. Jade Elizabeth Montes. Jorge Morales. Corian Robin Nathan. Angelique Marie Perez. Lana Rose Romero. Cristina Reyes. Ansel Mauricio Ramos. Elisa Annette Reyes. Gerardo Segundo Jr. Benjamin Luke Thomas. Gisela Alessandra Tovar Aguilar. Jamia Paris Warren. Marcus Clay Anderson. Denaya LaShawn Marie Holman Mack. Tyus Kevon Watson. Keelan Pharrell Wilson. McKinley Linnell Wilson. Jertorell Liel Beal.
Graduates, please stand. Please move your tassels from the right to the left side of your caps, symbolic of your graduation. I proudly present the Hall Success Academy graduating class of 2023. A reminder to the audience that you must exit through the doors at the rear of the arena. Please stand and remain standing until the graduates have recessed.